Dogumentary TV, producing the best breed documentaries.
Dogs, like no other animal, they have worked their way into our hearts and homes. Many of you are watching this video because you are thinking of bringing a new dog into your heart and home. It's my strong belief that if you're going to be buying a dog, you should find a responsible breeder. Dealing with a responsible breeder, you will likely be presented with a puppy contract. If you are not offered a puppy contract, the likelihood is that you are dealing with a backyard breeder. And even more likely, the person selling you the puppy is not responsibly breeding dogs. In this video, I'm going to go over what is outlined in a puppy contract and explain why these things are important when buying a new puppy. Many of you are aware of the fact that I recently bought a puppy. For this video, I will use my puppy contract as an outline, and I will do this because most puppy contracts are going to be unique to the breeder and to the breed. I will not be giving specifics on costs and my personal breeder, as many of these elements are specific to my purchase. Now, I know many of you want to know where I got my dog from, but I've never used this channel as a means to drive business to any specific breeder. I'm not going to start now. Since the switch to Dogumentary TV, I do not include breeder contact information, breeder websites in the videos. The breeder is simply there to share with you information on the breed. It is not an opportunity for the breeder to sell puppies. Okay, so let's get into the elements of a puppy contract. The first good sign of a puppy contract is the letterhead. A contract should be specific to the breeder, as opposed to just a general template that you can pull off the internet. The letterhead should show the breeder to be a licensed business registered with his or her resident state. The first section of the contract will identify the breeder as the seller and you, the customer, as the buyer. The next section on my contract identifies the sire, the dam, and the sex of the puppy and his pick and the pick that the puppy is in the litter. After that, the contract then identifies whether you're purchasing as a pet companion or as a working slash show dog. Pet companion dogs are typically sold with limited AKC registration, but still should have a full health guarantee. Show working dogs are sold with full AKC registration, a full health guarantee, and a conditional agreement for breeding. The conditions of breeding are outlined later in the contract. I will address that when I get there. Typically, you're going to pay a premium for working and show dogs. I will share with you guys that my dog Roscoe was the second pick male of his litter and sold as a working show quality dog. I specifically told my breeder that I wanted the best Rottweiler I could get, but I did not intend on breeding. So my assumption is that the first pick male was either kept by the breeder or sold to someone that the breeder has a breeding relationship with. Most breeders will not allow the first pick dogs, male or female, to go out without some sort of breeding considerations. Even though I don't have any intentions on breeding Roscoe, I still paid the premium for the full breeding rights because, one, I wanted the best dog I could possibly get, and two, I didn't want any strings attached to my purchase. The next section of the contract basically outlines the details of the purchase, outlining purchase price, delivery date, the breeder's responsibility to deliver you a sound and healthy dog, buyer's responsibility to inspect and assume possession of the dog. Once the buyer assumes possession, he is responsible for the health and well-being of the dog moving forward. This includes providing food, shelter, veterinary care, training, and socialization. Furthermore, the buyer agrees to maintain ownership of the dog. The buyer cannot sell or transfer ownership without the knowledge and consent of the seller. If for some reason the buyer cannot maintain ownership of the dog, he must return the dog to the seller. The next section of this contract details the health guarantees. The contract outlines the diseases and ailments that the puppy's parents have been examined and tested for. It also states your recourse should your puppy develop a severe genetic health disorder prior to 12 months of age. The next section outlines the companion dog non-breeding agreement. If you buy pet quality, this will apply to you. The buyer agrees that the dog will not be used for breeding. The buyer will receive limited AKC registration upon complete payment and proof of sterilization by a licensed veterinarian. I have heard from many folks that their breeder required sterilization at 6 months, and most breeders not later than 12 months. Many of you know that I'm not in favor of fixing dogs before they fully mature, which takes in some cases 2 to 3 years. This was another reason why I decided to go ahead and pay the premium for my puppy. The next section of the contract outlines the conditional agreement for breeding. These conditions will vary from breeder to breeder and breed to breed. Typical conditions are that the breeding dogs each are of a certain age before breeding, usually at least 2 years of age. They must pass the appropriate health tests. Hips, elbows, and hearts are typical. If there are any genetic issues specific to the breed, you will likely have to have the breeding dogs determined not to be carriers of said genetic issues. The breeding dogs must also be clear of any disqualifying faults according to the breeder's recognized kennel club. Usually there's some form of financial penalty if a dog is bred outside of the conditions agreed to in this contract. Alright guys, so that's generally what's covered in a puppy contract, but every responsible breeder will have specific requirements for purchasing a puppy. And these requirements will definitely be tailored to the breed and the breeder's program. As a buyer, you should embrace the constraints of a puppy contract as they typically prioritize the happiness of the dog, the health of the breed, the satisfaction of the buyer, the reputation of the breeder and his program. All right? Peace.